Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update this Monday, May 14. Aboard the orbiting complex, Station Commander Cosmonaut Oleg Kononenko and Flight Engineers European Space Agency astronaut Andre Kuipers and NASA astronaut Don Pettit begin their third week as the Expedition 31 crew and their 21st week in space. Meanwhile, back on Earth, cosmonauts Gennady Padalka and Sergey Revin and NASA astronaut Joe Akaba are now in their sleep period in Baikonur, Kazakhstan, from where they will launch aboard their Soyuz 04M to the International Space Station in a little less than 12 hours. Final countdown of tonight's launch from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan will begin at 2 p.m. Central Time. Live coverage of the launch will begin here on NASA television at 9 p.m. Central Time, 10 p.m. Eastern Time. That'll be followed by the liftoff at 10:01 p.m. Central Time. The trio will join the crew aboard the orbiting complex on Wednesday when their Soyuz spacecraft docks to the Poisk module after their two-day voyage to the station. Live coverage of the Soyuz launch, docking, and hatch opening will be aired here on NASA television. Again, that launch coverage will begin tonight at 9 p.m. Central Time. Today, Station Commander Oleg Kononenko is busy with some maintenance work to pump wastewater to a water tank aboard Progress for its eventual disposal, while Flight Engineers Andre Kuipers and Don Pettit work together to perform the closeout of a replacement of one of the station's attitude control systems, GPS. The repair work is to recover communication connection of the failed GPS that was discovered late last week. The replacement is necessary to accommodate the upcoming rendezvous and docking of SpaceX's Dragon commercial spacecraft that is scheduled to launch at the end of this week on May 19. Earlier this morning, Commander Kononenko spent some time monitoring a Russian study known as Matryoshka that looks at radiation exposure of long-term spaceflight. He also spent some time this morning collecting air samples for analysis, performed some maintenance to the Russian life support system known as Soj, and also conducted the quarterly maintenance to the onboard treadmill exercise equipment. Flight engineers Don Pettit had spent his morning working to reestablish communication connection with the failed GPS and also troubleshoot with the ground controllers before setting up to remove and replace it with an onboard spare. He and Andre Kuipers also spent some time this morning collecting biological samples in participation of the energy experiment. That experiment measures the changes in energy balance during long-term spaceflight.